Hey guys, Drew Brashler. I am here today with another effects tutorial just for you. Now, today we're going to be talking about the Ultimo Compressor. And the Ultimo Compressor is an emulation of the 1176 made by Universal Audio. Now, this thing is famous. There's so many different things about this thing that's awesome. One of the main things it's really well known for is its crazy fast attack. Now, by crazy fast, I mean 20 microseconds. Now, microseconds is faster than milliseconds. So this thing is so incredibly fast. Now, I did not make any time measurements as far as attack and release on this because it's so fast. I imagine that it's going to be faster than the ability that I'm going to be able to measure in an accurate sense. So hopefully Behringer has taken the attack and release settings from the emulation of the 1176 and applied it to the Ultimo Compressor. Now let's go ahead and just hop in. Now I already have this assigned to Effects Rack 6, and I have this actually inserted on my overheads from my drums. Now there's two main things that I love using the 1176 for. Now one thing is going to be using it for drum overheads and making them just shine and give a lot more activity and just a little bit more oomph to them. And then the other thing that I love using this on is bass guitar, because there's a certain setting inside the Ultimo Compressor that you can use to give it a lot of distortion and compression all in the same effect, which is pretty awesome. So let's go ahead and dive in and actually see the different controls that we have on this. So this is the Ultimo Compressor. This is the stereo version. There's also a dual, so we can go ahead and rotate the dual. If you're going to be using a stereo source like drum overheads, in my sense, I'm going to be using the stereo version, and we can also use the dual for multiple inputs. So now that we're here, we have our input gain right here, and this is on dB scale. Now, Behringer did this great because 1 dB on the effect is actually 1 dB in reality. So when you turn this up 1 dB, you will expect to see a 1 dB increase. Now, the input gain is not only the input gain to the compressor, but is also setting the threshold as well. So if you take this and turn this to the right or a higher value, you are going to be getting more compression. If you turn this to the left, you are going to be lowering the gain and getting less compression. Now, equally, we have our output gain. The output gain is post-compression, so no matter how much you turn this up or down, it will not affect the compression that's actually taking place. This is only a makeup gain. Now, also, 1 dB here on the effect is 1 dB in reality, which is amazing. So if we turn this up, we're going to be getting more gain. If we turn this down, we're going to be getting less gain. The next knob that we have here is attack. Now, attack is going to be as how fast the compressor actually attacks a signal. The settings here are different than normal compressors. If you want to have a faster attack, I'm going to take my attack knob and turn it to the right or a higher value. And if I take my attack knob and turn it to the left, it's going to result in a slower attack. Same thing with the release. If I turn this to the right, it's going to have a faster release. If I turn this to the left, it's going to have a slower release. Lastly, we have our ratio. Now we have four different adjustments here and then also an all button mode. So we can rotate this. We have 4, 8, 12, 20, and all. Now, all is a pretty cool thing on the original 1176. It allowed you to choose multiple ratio buttons at the same time. Now, when we set this to all, it is going to have a ratio somewhere in between 12 to 1 and 20 to 1. It's basically just going to give a completely different sound. And so if you're wanting to have a compression, you'll want to have this ratio set in 4 to 8. If you're wanting to have this as a limiter, you're going to want this on 12 to 1, 20 to 1, or all. Now, one thing that I want to mention here is the input gain. When we are talking about a full strength signal, we're talking about unity gain. Now, unity gain on this console is somewhere between negative 18 and negative 15 dB full scale, which is dBFS. Now, on a normal signal, at negative 15 dBFS, which is two orange lights on your console, if you have your input gain to set to negative 33 and your output gain set to negative 21, you will have pretty much a unity gain on this effect with zero compression. Once your signal of your channel goes above negative 15 dBFS, you will start compressing. Now, Once we have that set, we can go ahead and start adjusting this up or down. If we're wanting to have more compression on that channel, you can start raising this or lowering it. So as just kind of a default starting settings for using this compressor, I would set to negative 33 on the input, negative 21 on the output, put your attack to 3, put your release to 5, and have a ratio of 4. Those are going to be some very good starting settings if you're using this for the first time. So let's go ahead and actually get my drums going into this thing and see how this sounds on some drum overheads to add a little bit of liveliness into them. Okay, so now that we actually have some audio going through this, I have my Ultimo compressor inserted on my stereo overhead. So we're going to go ahead and solo my overheads here, and now we're just listening to all of the stuff that's going into this channel, including this effect that's inserted on it. So if we go ahead and turn up our input gain, we'll not only hear that it's going louder, but we'll also hear that eventually our compression is going to start kicking in. So I'm going to turn this up and our output gain down. All right, so we are already having a little bit of compression here going on. Now let's go ahead and listen to the attack times and release times here. So my attack, I'm not wanting to have too fast, because if I have it too fast, it's going to just clamp down on that hi-hat, like so. Okay. And so if I have this down too slow, there's not going to be enough compression happening for this. So I'm going to want to have this set to the point where I have enough attack happening, but still all of my transients coming through. Now that sounds pretty great. Now let's go ahead and hit the release time now. So if I have my release too fast, or if I have my release too slow, it's not going to come back up as fast as I want it to. So I'm going to want to set this to the point where it's going to be releasing before the next hit, but also not creating a pumping sound. And a pumping sound is where you can definitely hear the compression happening. So let's go ahead and actually check out the ratio now. So if I have it set at 4, it's just going to be mild compression. If I turn this to 8, it's going to have more compression. And then when I hit 12 and 20, it's going to be in limiting mode. And then my all mode, so the all button mode, is actually going to gain 1 decibel on the effect. So just FYI, if you decide to use all button mode, it is going to add 1 dB. That just sounds crazy. So the one thing that I love this for is adding a little bit of liveliness into my drum overhead. So I'm going to go ahead and start playing this and unsolo my drum overhead so you can hear the entire thing. And I'm going to activate and deactivate this effect here. Okay, so we have the full drums kind of going on in here, and we can hear that there's not a lot of room sound. But if I turn this up, it's just going to overdrive my signal by adding in a whole lot too many cymbals. So what we're going to do is we're just going to add in the Ultimo compressor here. Now, the place that I hear this the most is in the kick drum. If you'll hear the room sound with the kick drum on this, you'll really hear that just open up with the overheads. Now, remember, my input gain and my output gain are to the point where I'm not adding much signal, but I am getting a very big increase in the amount for my overheads. Now, the other place that I love using this is bass guitar. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up some bass guitar, and we can insert this and get some really awesome sounds going from that. So I have my music going through the board now here, and I have my Ultimo compressor inserted on my bass guitar. So let's go ahead and just solo the bass guitar here. And I have my bass settings that I have set here. We can see that my signal is about negative 15 dBFS. And so I have my input gain set to negative 33, my output gain set to negative 21, my attack, my release, and my ratio here. And so we can see that if it gets really loud here in a portion of the song, that I'll start seeing some compression happening every now and then. Now, if I wanted to have more compression, basically I would just start turning this up, and we can see that we are starting to get a little bit of compression here. Now, once you have that set, we'll want to turn down our output gain to the point where we're keeping our input and our output about the same. Now, the best way to tell this is by pressing the active button. And we can see that that's very, very even. Now, with the bass guitar, what I'm wanting to do is I'm wanting to give it that really good, awesome grit that the Ultimo and the 1176 are really well known for. So to do that, I'm basically going to take my attack and turn this up to 7, and my release and turn that to 7. And so that is creating that really good fuzz bass sound that some people really, really love. Now, this is even with a ratio of 4:1, and we're not doing a whole mess of compression on this signal. So if we now go and turn this all the way up to all, it is not only giving a lot of compression and a lot of that grit from the attack and release, but also the ratio from the all is giving it a little bit more of that grit that we want. And so if I go ahead and deactivate this here, so we can really hear that coming through. Now, we're not adding a lot of signal, we're not compressing a whole lot on this, but we are adding that grit sound. Thank you so much for watching this video on the Ultimo compressor. It's a really great tool for being able to add a little bit of liveliness to the drum overheads, a little bit of grit to the bass guitar. Now, you can also use this for snare drums or acoustic guitars or electric guitars. It's a very useful tool for kind of all over the board. Just remember that if you are starting out, set your attack to 3, your release to 5, and have your ratio set to 4:1. And that's going to be a really good basis to kind of start sculpting your sound with this effect. If you have any questions, feel free to post below. Also, make sure to check out my blog post, which you can see right here, that goes along with this video. And lastly, if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to my channel down below. You will be getting the most up-to-date videos that I'm releasing on the X32. Thank you so much.